Hello YouTube, and welcome to this video about the lesser known gods of the Elder Scrolls universe. I lately got a lot of inspiration to do top 5 videos, but there was this tiny little voice in my head that said,
don't do top 5 videos.
So, like every sane person, I listened to the voices inside my head and I decided not to do a top 5 video. I will do a top 6 video. Instead, I will do a top 6 video about some lesser known gods of the Elder Scrolls universe. I will give small explanations of all the gods, but I would be busy over 2 hours if I gave a whole lore explanation on every god, so it will be kind of short and more of a summary. So with that said, let's kick off. Number 6, Trinimac. This deity is one a lot of people probably heard about, but even still, a lot of people don't tend to know, well, who he is. Trinimac was one of the Ed'Ada, or original spirits. He is a champion of the High Elven Pantheon, and one of the strongest of the Aedra. He is, in some places of the Somerset Isles, very fanatically worshipped, even to the point of being more popular with the High Elves than Auriel, the King of Gods. There is a theory within the Elder Scrolls universe that Trinimac transformed to Malekith by the Daedric Prince Boethia. This theory is widely believed by the Orcs, who actually believe that the followers of Trinimac became the Orcs after his transformation into Malekith. This, however, is not believed by the Snow Elves and the High Elves, who still have Trinimac as a deity in their pantheon and very fanatically worship him. Number 5. Ifri, or Yefri. I don't know how to say this. He's a god appearing in the Bosmeri, Aldmeri and Brittany and Khajiiti pantheon. He is by far the most important god in the Bosmeri pantheon, as he is the spirit of the now, or how obscure that may sound, it's true. The Wood Elves or Bosmer think that Ifri was the one that made himself into the first Elnofe, after every living thing had turned into a plant or wild animal after the creation. They believed that he was the one that, after the mortals returned, taught the Bosmer their way of life. Therefore, he is called the Storyteller. In the other pantheons, however, he is less important, as the other pantheons merely see him as the god of the forest, and not as their teacher. Number 4. Xarxes. Xarxes is the Aldmeri and Bosmeri god of knowledge and ancestry, specifically secret knowledge. They believed that Xarxes began as a scribe, in the service of Auriel, and that he was to write down all the great accomplishments of Auriel and the Elnofe since the very beginning of the universe. This giant heap of knowledge had him craving for more knowledge until he met Hermaeus Mora, who used Xarxes to have some of his knowledge written down in physical form. Xarxes wrote the Ogma Infernum, a record of some of the knowledge Hermaeus Mora bestowed upon Xarxes, and it's become the object that is most associated with Xarxes. The book is named after his own wife, who was named Ogma. It's said that he created her out of his favorite memories of the history. Number 3. Tsun. Yeah, we've all seen him in Sovngarde, but a lot of people actually don't know what he stands for and what he is. He actually is the Nordic god of trials. He was one of Shore's shield thanes, and it's believed that by Nords that he is the one that died defending Shore against the other gods. He actually had a brother, Stun. You get it? Tsun and Stun? It's really confusing. Who was the other shield thane of Shore at the time? He is actually the only one on this list that we can actually physically meet, as he is the one guarding the bridge to Shore's Hall in Sovngarde in Skyrim. There the player has to fight him to gain the right to enter Shore's Hall. After the creation of the Pantheon, the Nine Divines, he was, together with his brother Stun, made into Stendarr. However, this is what a lot of people believe nowadays. It's not really true, as we can meet Tsun, and therefore it's quite, well, he's not Stendarr. Really, he is not, because we can meet him. Number 2. Abinarm. Yeah, I'm going to give Abinarm a mention. He has become, well, by far the most well-known of the lesser-known gods, as he is the one that has mysteriously been removed by Bethesda from all games since Daggerfall. Just removed, not in lore, just from the entire game. book that once mentioned him, for example, have the lines where he was mentioned removed from the books, and the book has just been put out in the games, but he has just been removed from it. I think that's kind of strange, but thanks to Daggerfall we still have an idea of who he was. Abenarm, or Raymond Abenarm, was the Yokuden god of war. He was the protector and companion of all warriors, and apparently the enemy of all Daedric princes, Stendar, and apparently the Mages Guild. However, he does seem to have some strange liking for Shir Goreth, as he is not the enemy of Shir Goreth, but they're not allies. He apparently rides a golden stallion called Warmaster, and he has a strong appearance. He's said to always wear ebony armor and that he has red hair. He apparently has a steel blue eyes that pierce through the helmet like thunder, and his right arm is fused with an ebony sword. And finally, number one, Mauluk. This one is a weird one. I chose him as number one because he has such a weird title. It's Mauluk, Fart of the Mountain. Yes, Fart of the Mountain. Amazing. He's the orcish god of mountains, specifically the High Velethi Mountains. Some orcs believe that he has something to do with the eruption of Red Mountain. They say that his rage may have been a factor in the eruption. But that's actually all we know about him. But I just thought that, well, that name just... I don't know, it deserved number one. Well guys, I hope you liked this little top 6 list. Something else for a change than the normal lore videos. I quite enjoyed making it, but I probably won't make any more top 6 or top 5 lists for a few months and just continue with the normal formula lore videos, because I still like that better. That said, I hope you liked it, and if you did, like and subscribe. You can follow my Instagram or join my Discord in the description. And when you did all that, I will see you in the next lore video.